Hello. In today's video, we shall learn in detail about Mendel's laws of inheritance. By the end of this video, you'll have a clear understanding about law of dominance, law of segregation, law of independent assortment, incomplete dominance, codominance, multiple alleles, backcross, and test cross. Let us begin with the introduction to Mendelian inheritance. Mendel is known as the father of genetics. Mendel conducted hybridization experiments on garden pea plant Pisum sativum and discovered the scientific principles which govern the patterns of inheritance. He explained that contrasting characters are controlled by units which are called factors. Mendel chose pea plants for his experiments because of the following reasons. Garden pea is an annual plant with a short lifespan, so few generations could be grown in a year. Pea plants bear bisexual flowers which are large and easy to handle. The flowers are naturally self-pollinating and so pure line of traits can be obtained. The flowers can easily be cross-pollinated for conducting experiments. Pea plant exhibits many varieties with distinguished contrasting characters. The plant can be raised, cultivated, and maintained conveniently for experimental purposes. The pea plant produces many seeds. The pea plant has various contrasting characters among its different varieties. Seeds may be round or wrinkled. Seed color may be yellow or green. Color of flower may be violet or white. Ripe pods may be inflated or constricted. Unripe pods may be green or yellow. Flowers may be axial or terminal in position, and the stem may be tall or dwarf. By the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, please like and share this video so that all of us can learn, unlearn, and relearn together. Also, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Next, let us learn about Mendel's experiments with pea plant. Mendel adopted self-fertilization method to rear genetically pure variety of pea plants for a single character. Mendel started with pure lines and confirmed after many generations that the parents are true breeding. He obtained parental tall plant with factors capital T, capital T, and dwarf with small t, t. Mendel cross-pollinated both the varieties and observed that in the first filial generation, F1, all the plants were tall. He allowed selfing of F1 hybrids and observed that the character of dwarfness, which had disappeared in the first generation, had reappeared in the second generation. The ratio of tall dominant plants and recessive dwarf plants was 3:1 and is known as the phenotypic ratio. The ratio of pure tall to hybrid tall and dwarf is 1:2:1. This is known as the genotypic ratio. On the basis of the results obtained through his hybridization experiments, Mendel formulated three laws, namely law of dominance, law of segregation, and law of independent assortment. Law of dominance. It is the first law of inheritance. It states that in crossing between pure homozygous organisms for contrasting characters of a pair, only one character of the pair appears in the first filial generation. The cross between the pea plants differing in single pair of contrasting characters is known as monohybrid cross. Mendel made a monohybrid cross between tall and dwarf pea plants. In the first filial generation, only tall plants appeared. The character that appears in the F1 generation is called dominant, and the one which is suppressed is called recessive. When F1 progeny were allowed to self-fertilize, both tall and dwarf characters appeared in the second filial generation because the character of tallness dominated the character of dwarfness. The production of gametes, the formation of zygote, the F1 and F2 generations can be predicted with the help of Punnett square. The Punnett square is a square diagram or a graphical representation to determine the probability of an offspring having a particular genotype in a genetic cross. The diagram shown depicts a Punnett square, which is used to understand a typical monohybrid cross conducted by Mendel between true breeding tall plants and true breeding dwarf plants. Next is law of segregation. It is the second law of inheritance, also known as the law of purity of gametes. Members of allelic pair in a hybrid remain together without mixing with each other and segregate at the time of gametogenesis so that each gamete receives only one character, either dominant or recessive. A homozygous parent produces all similar gametes, while a heterozygous parent produces two kinds of gametes, each having one allele. Law of segregation can be explained by a monohybrid cross. Reappearance of recessive trait in F2 generation proves the law. Next, let us have a closer look at the law of independent assortment. It is the third law of inheritance. When two homozygous parents differing in two pairs of contrasting characters are crossed, then the inheritance of one pair of factors is independent to that of the other pair of factors. When we cross two pure breeding homozygous pea plants, one with yellow round seeds and one with green wrinkled seeds, the gametes which are produced by capital YYRR and small letter YYRR plants are capital Y, capital R and small letter YR respectively. The two types of gametes fuse to give rise to the F1 hybrid. Since they are heterozygous for two genes, the F1 plants are called dihybrids. The F1 hybrid has four types of gametes, capital Y, capital R, capital Y, small r, small y, capital R, and small y, small r. Independent assortment takes place during meiosis. During gametogenesis, one pair of traits segregate from another pair of traits independently. The four types of gametes of F1 hybrid unite during fertilization and forms 16 types of individuals in F2 generation. The 9 different genotypes are capital Y, capital Y, capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y, capital R, small letter R, capital Y, small y, capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y, small r, small r, capital Y, small r, small r, small letter Y, small y, capital R, capital R, small letter Y, capital R, small r, and small letters YYRR. The genotypic ratio is 1:2:2:4:1:2:1:2:1:2:1. Due to dominance, there are only 4 phenotypes: yellow round, yellow wrinkled, green round, and green wrinkled. The phenotypic ratio is 9:3:3:1. Next is incomplete dominance. The law of dominance does not occur universally. In incomplete dominance, both the genes of an allelomorphic pair express themselves partially, as one gene cannot dominate and suppress the other completely. Intermediate characters in F1 generation occurs. Incomplete dominance is seen in the flower color of snapdragon antirrhinum majus. When a red flowered snapdragon plant with genotype capital R capital R is crossed with white flowered snapdragon plant with genotype small r small r, the F1 hybrid plants appeared with pink flowers, genotype capital R, small r. Both the parental traits, red and white, reappear in F2 generation. Phenotypic and genotypic ratios are identical, 1:2:1. Next is codominance. In codominance, both the dominant and the recessive characters express themselves equally in F1 hybrid. Best example of codominance is coat color in cattle. When a cattle of red coat is crossed with a cattle of white coat, the F1 hybrid possesses roan coat. Roans have red and white hair in definite patches. Interbreeding of roans in F2 generation produces red with genotype capital R capital R, roan with genotype capital R capital W, and white with genotype capital W capital W in the ratio 1:2:1. The genotypic and the phenotypic ratios are identical. Next is multiple alleles. They are alternate forms of the same gene occupying the same locus on the chromosome. Wild type is dominant over all other mutant alleles. An example of multiple alleles is the ABO blood group in human beings. The gene capital I controls the ABO blood group. It has 3 alleles, IA, IB, and small letter I. Capital IA and capital IB alleles are codominant with each other and are both dominant over the small I allele. There are 6 different genotypes and only 4 different phenotypes found in human blood group. Finally, we shall try to understand backcross and testcross. the breeding of F1 generation with any one of its parents is known as back cross. In a monohybrid cross of homozygous tall and homozygous dwarf pea plant, the F1 heterogeneous tall plant is crossed with either its dominant parent or with its recessive parent. When F1 hybrid is crossed with its dominant parent, all the plants produced are 100% tall, and no recessive individuals are obtained in the progeny. Back cross helps in obtaining pure lines. It is used to determine the genotype of parent plants and F1 individuals. It also helps in explaining law of segregation and the law of independent assortment. Desirable characters can also be introduced by back crossing. A cross between F1 hybrid and its homozygous recessive parent is called a test cross. Since the offspring is crossed back with one of its parent, it is also called as back cross. All test crosses are back crosses. Mendel used test cross to verify the genotype of F1 hybrids. When F1 hybrid, which is heterozygous for tall, is crossed with its recessive, the result of F2 generation shows 50% tall and 50% dwarf plants in the ratio 1:1. In the case of a dihybrid cross, the test cross genotypic and phenotypic ratio of 1:1:1:1 are obtained. A test cross can help in determining if a dominant phenotype is homozygous or heterozygous for a particular trait. It is used to determine the genetic constitution of an individual. Desirable characters in homozygous conditions can be obtained. So today, we have learnt in detail about Mendel's law of inheritance with different examples: incomplete dominance, codominance, multiple alleles, back cross, and test cross. I have some practice questions for you. Please share your answers in the comments section below. You can pause the video and write down the questions if you like. Thank you so much for your time and participation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Also, if you want to discuss any particular topic in biology, please mention that in the comments section below. I'll see you there. Goodbye. All the best.